Today, we are gonna fix CS2 VAC was unable to verify your game session problem. Before moving on to the video, don't forget to leave a like. I recommend watching the video once before trying the solutions. This problem was also encountered in CSGO. I shared the solution video of this problem on my channel, and it was useful for thousands of people. After watching this video, your problem will be solved. The first solution consists of several small steps. The first step is to clean temporary files. To do this, press the Windows and R keys at the same time to open run. After that, type %lookup data% and click OK. In the opened folder, we locate the temp folder. Once we find it, select everything inside the temp folder and delete it. If we encounter file in use, we tick do this for all current items and click skip. There might be more files in your temp folder than mine. I have fewer files because I have cleaned the temp folder previously. The second step is to remove CS2's launch options. To do this, open Steam and right-click on CS2. After that, click on Properties. Then, make sure that the launch options section is empty. The third step is to change our Steam name. To do this, click on our profile on the right, and then click on View My Profile. After that, click on Edit. Once this is done, we change the profile name. This is seemingly simple step is actually quite effective. After changing the profile name, scroll down and click on Save. The fourth and final step is to delete the download cache. To do this, click on Steam in the upper left corner, then click on Settings. After that, go to Downloads and click on Clear Cache. To proceed, click on Confirm. After doing this, we open Steam as an admin and log into our account. Once we have logged in, you can check if the problem is solved or not. If the issue persists, we will move on to the second solution. The second solution, which also resolved this issue for me, is changing the location of a DLL within Steam. This will not cause any harm to Steam. It is safe to do. To do this, we open File Explorer. Then we need to open the disk where Steam is installed. In my case, Steam is installed on D drive, so I will continue with D. After that, click on Program Files x86. Then open the Steam folder and double click on the bin. Once we have done that, locate the Steam service.dll file and copy it. We need to put this file in Steam folder inside Common Files folder. This folder is usually located on C drive. We open C drive and double click on Program Files x86. As you can see, Common Files is here. We open the Common Files folder and then open Steam folder. After doing this, we paste the copied file here. We click Replace the file in the destination and then click Continue. Now, you can check if the problem is solved or not. If the issue persists, we will move on to the third solution. If the first two solutions didn't work for you, the problem might be related to system or game files. If that's the case, verifying these files can resolve the problem. To verify system files, open the search section and run CMD as an admin. After that, we type sfc/scannow into the CMD. This code won't harm our system. It is a simple code that allows us to verify system files. Since it verifies all system files, this process may take some time. We have verified the system files. Now, let's verify the files for CS2. To do this, open Steam and right-click on CS2. Then, click on Properties and click Installed Files. After that, click on Verify Integrity of Game Files. This process will also take some time. We have verified the files for CS2. Now, you can check whether the problem is solved or not. We have come to the end of the video. I hope one of these solutions fixed your problem. If the video helped you, don't forget to like the video. You can also subscribe to my channel to support me. Take care, and see you in the next video.